Following the killing of Daunte Wright, the state mobilized the National Guard after crowds gathered in front of the Brooklyn Center Police Department on Sunday evening, and a curfew was ordered through Monday morning. I believe we have some footage that we can put up as we're discussing this. But outside of the Brooklyn Center Police Department on Sunday night, smoke billowed into the air as a line of police officers fired rubber bullets and chemical agents at protesters, some of whom lobbed rocks, bags of garbage, and water bottles at the police. At around 11:30 last night, Brooklyn Center Police declared the crowd an unlawful assembly and said anyone who remained at the scene, including journalists, would be arrested. Because it's America, and you can do that apparently, because the crowd is inconvenient. Anyway, so I am assuming that there's probably a similar situation there right now. We'll find out more as the day goes on. I would assume that, barring some sort of far quicker than normal response to this from the police department, a far quicker than normal response that's actually serious and takes into account all that we've been discussing here so far today, it is likely that that same sort of protest will continue to manifest there. Again, especially considering the context of where this particular police killing happened.
Absolutely. And once again, the response proves the point of the protesters, the violence, the rubber bullets, the tear gas, these non-lethal weapons that do this cruel thing of proving that both cops are armed to the teeth with things that don't actually kill people, but maim and stall people. And also that they are willing to use violence when faced with non-violence, whenever possible, yeah. Really. It's almost like they have too much money.
It's almost like it, but don't know. No, because you're getting closer to defunding. It's just, this is the narratives, the conversation. No, it's so bad, yeah. Francesca, that not only should we not do that, we shouldn't do anything, in fact. It's, it could like endanger an incumbent in 6 years or something. We should just let the killings continue. That is unfortunately a parody I am doing of virtually every Democrat.
Absolutely.
Not all of them. There are some good ones, but more than there should be. So look, we've been giving updates as they've been coming. It is possible we're missing things. That's, you know, sort of one of the costs of doing a show like this live. I apologize. But we will be sticking with the story. I'm sure we'll have more on tomorrow's episode of the Damage Report. And you can expect that Anna and Cenk will be talking about it on the Young Turks as well. I would guarantee that. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.